quick tip. I have a recipe that I have just started, and the recipe calls for cutting butter into flour. What I have is one stick of butter, and you'll see that it is in little slices, about 1/4 inch wide, each one of those, and I should have separated those a little bit better, but that's to help in having some separation at the beginning and not having the whole stick at the beginning, but we'll work with that in just a second. I have 2 1/4 cups of flour, self-rising flour, but that just depends on your recipe. You might be cutting this into a cake mix or whatever. So now what we're going to do is use a pastry blender. If you don't have this, you can use a fork. And we're going to just start separating these best we can. And I'll just take my spoon to help with that. And once we get them separated out, then we'll start cutting with either a fork or a pastry blender. You want the butter to be very cold. And you might be surprised at that, because usually when we put butter in something that we're baking, we'll say get it to room temperature because it'll be easy to blend in. What you're trying to do is to cut this in instead of blend it. You don't want to use a mixer. You don't want to smash it and try to combine it with the flour. Actually, you want to keep a separation between the butter and the flour. But you want it finer and finer and finer. You want it chopped. So you just keep working in a motion like this, and occasionally you'll need to scrape that down and go again at it. We'll keep doing this until it is like coarse cornmeal. And that will be a mixture of butter and flour, but the butter will still be maintained. It won't be compressed into the flour. So that's what you're going to see when I finish with my cutting the butter into the flour. So here we have it. We have the butter cut into the flour. And see what a nice texture it has? It's crumbly, and you can actually almost see those little bits of butter. And it's important to keep that separation between the butter and the flour, because if you're baking something like biscuits or some cakes and things like that, when they go into the oven and get heated, that butter will melt, and then you'll have the joining of the flour and the butter, and it will be just perfect in terms of how it rises.